This is the new lightning electric scooter from Nanrobot. It has these unique 8-inch wide wheels, dual 800-watt motors, a top speed around 30 miles per hour or 48 kilometers an hour. There's dual disc brakes, a 48 volt 18 amp hours battery to give an estimated range around 20 to 25 miles or 30 to 40 kilometers, and dual suspension for that smooth ride. What's up guys, Ben here from AuthenTech, and today we're checking out this lightning electric scooter. Huge thanks to Nanrobot for sponsoring today's video.
Rolling. You need some help?
No, 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 this is, you gotta capture the struggle. Assembly's easy and straightforward. Just take it out of the box. It's well packaged and protected. There's a mounting bracket that needs to go over the handlebars. Just position it to your liking and lock it down tight. And then just tighten down the other instruments on the handlebar, and that's basically it. The price tag on this one's more budget friendly, which is nice. The Lightning's currently going for $1,300. All links, as always, are down below. So first impressions, just got it out of the box. It's nice and small. We have these 8-inch tires, which is smaller than I'm used to, but they look kind of fun and nimble and flat and wide. Rear fender, this is good for carrying around, plus putting that foot back here for support. You got your grip tape, you got nice high clearance for making those jumps. Swing arms, which is my favorite, good for off-roading suspension. I just had to tighten this stuff down, which is pretty fast and easy. Nice tightening knob, easy to open and close to fold down and transport. Really good shocks, I love that swing arm. This should be good for the off-roading. Nice cute little kickstand, well placed, good amount of lean. All right, and the horn? That's good, that's good. It's not too sissy and it's loud enough that people will hear you. All right, she's all set up. Let's go out for the first test ride. My buddy Nick and I went riding for an afternoon. We put it through its paces and we both walked away feeling way more impressed than what we might have preconceived. Just shows you, you can't judge a book by its cover. It simply feels more nimble and lightweight and agile with these smaller but wide wheel tires. Even though the tires are non-inflatable, those shock arms are pretty incredible, and we beat this thing up pretty bad and she's still hauling us all around. Plus, don't forget the benefit of puncture-proof solid tires. There's no worries of getting a flat, which is nice. Those 8-inch tires give you this lower to the ground center of gravity, which actually aids in some nice stability when riding, both on or off-road. Plus, they're still wide enough that you don't feel like you're gonna get bucked off if you hit a small crack. This thing just keeps rolling over and through all kinds of tough terrain. We even went cruising through some wooded terrain that was pretty thick, and this Nanrobot blazed through it just fine. Now you see, a part of a good, powerful scooter, I'd say, is rule number one, dual motors. You need that front and rear wheel drive to help you rip over and through all terrain that you put it through. Now another example, we found this really steep grassy hill that was a little muddy, and going both down and up it had no problems at all, which is pretty impressive. There's front and rear disc brakes, plus electronic brakes as well, which is a nice option to turn on or off. The scooter can come to a halt pretty dang fast. Just don't forget to lean back and please wear a helmet. One of my new favorite moves is to race through the grass, then with a little bit of practice, lock up that rear tire brake, kick it out sideways, it sort of power slides, and this one's a blast to do, especially if the ground's wet or slick. The scooter weight is approximately 65 pounds or 29 kilograms. It's lightweight enough to easily pop up and over curbs, plus with that sweet ground clearance and bouncy swing arms, we can bunny hop fairly easily as well. To really test it out, I had Nick first jump off the bench seat on this picnic table, and the scooter handled it no problem.
Let's try it. Easy. Listen to it. All right, we started the low. Now let's try the tippity top. Tippity top.
Ready?
Ready. Oh, easy. This thing is a beast for how small these little 8-inch are.
Now, I would not recommend you doing stuff like this. It might hurt it, but this is why I beat the heck out of these things, just so you guys don't have to. Now, since that scooter weight isn't all that heavy, the Nanrobot scooters have this nice knob locking mechanism for opening and closing. It's fairly easy enough to fold the scooter in half, toss it in your trunk, and then fasten and easy to unfold the handlebar and lock it down tight and zip off and away. Max speed is rated at 30 miles per hour, and believe me, that is plenty fast on almost any electric scooter. She is zippy and can get up and going pretty quick. There's three speed modes plus single or dual drive mode. These are always nice to have. For example, if I'm racing off-road, I like to kick it in high gear with dual motors turned on. And then later if I'm taking a joy cruise around the lake or maybe I'm needing to go that extra distance, I can pop it into single mode or slower speed mode and then my battery range will be extended. Speaking of, they say estimated range on a full battery charge is around 30 to 35 kilometers or 20 to 25-ish miles. Now, to fully charge with just that one charger included in the box, it can take around 8 to 10 hours. However, if you need a faster recharge, you can always purchase a second charger, and that cuts the time down in approximately half, 4 to 5 hours for a full charge. Also, on a quick side note, I really dig this barrel port design. I kind of wish all my electric scooters adopted this design. For context, a lot of scooters use that 3-pin connector thing that has this tiny slot that must be aligned perfectly, and I can't tell you how many times I fumbled with the chargers trying to twist it and align it just perfectly. Plus, I'm crawling around on the dirty garage floor as they're usually positioned on the underbelly. So as a breath of fresh air, the Nanrobot Lightning, I think of it almost like USB Type-C. It doesn't matter which way the plug is rotated, just uncap the port, plug it in blindly, and I'm off. Let me show you guys a few other features that I really like. The horn is fairly loud. Now, it's not too sissy, definitely not quiet, which I appreciate. I think of these horns as a great safety feature in case you ever need to catch some reckless driver's attention. I also really like that metal rear fender for putting my foot up for off-roading stability, and even pulling up and away to practice those killer wheelies. There's a handle for carrying around, plus it's a slot for when it folds down to click in half for portability. And there's two more fenders, front and back, for when running through the puddles, preventing that splash up, which is nice. The Lightning has some great LED lights. There's multiple up front for the dusk and low light riding, plus rear red lights that blink when braking and turning indicator switch. Plus there's two blue LED strips along the side of that riding deck that complete that cool cyan look. So that is the Nanrobot Lightning electric scooter. I hope this video was fun or helpful. Consider sticking around for more scooters, drones, and other fun tech video content posting soon. And I'll see you guys in the next one.
Alright, kick it!
I hope you got that!